Good afternoon, everybody. The intention of this webinar is first and foremost to try and pass on what could be actionable and useful information to other developers who are watching us. And I'd like this question to be answered by both of you. Is what process improvements and tweaks did you do and did you have to do and to adjust to work from home and to kind of build productivity, you know, in that new scenario?
So at Moonfrog, we are organized into what is called pod structure, a smaller group of 4, 5, maybe 7, 8 people who are collectively trying to chase a target or trying to build a feature or basically trying to achieve a goal. And these teams are self-contained, self-structured, and they work with producers around it. So for us, when we move to work from home, in a week's time, we first realized that the biggest breakdown that we are facing is communication. At the end of the day, that is the heart and soul of what we do. There is my time where I'm sitting, writing a spec or doing a design or making an art or write code. And then there is us time where we're actually debating, deciding what is to be done, what is good, what is not good, what is working, what is not working. So the me time was working well in office and the us time was also good. But when we went, both of them took a hit. And we were surprised. We thought that, hey, why is the me time taking a hit? Because you are still at home, you're still working. Why is that a problem? So what we did was we, instead of just making assumptions, we spent some time actually talking to every engineer, QA, most of them. And we really tried to find out what's working. And we found out that what was happening was communication was turning super noisy. We are all on Slack. Now, once you're on home, everybody can ping you on Slack at whatever given point of time. There's just no in time, there's no out time. Everybody can place a call whenever they feel like. And this was leading to anxiety. So just imagine if you're in an office, people can walk up to you, tap on your back and say, yeah, 2 minute hai kya, and then ask a question. But that would happen, say, 4 or 5 times in a day. But in the Slack world, you can get a ping anytime. And there would be hundreds of channels and anybody can ping and it's not even urgent or important and in not flavor, these things are coming in. So we needed to adapt to solve for communication. And for that, what we actually did was we made 4 things very explicit. Instead of defining this is the working hours and this is not the working hour, we said it is every pod's decision to make their own timing, but have an explicit start, have an explicit end. In the middle, have at least 3 hours of what we call as no ad hoc time. That means if you have a planned meeting, sure, you can go and do that meeting. But if suddenly some flip happens in a business, oh, I need to talk to Vaibhav about this, hold on. Give Vaibhav those 2 or 3 hours because he might be busy on his work and then do it. So it felt a bit restricting initially, but it really worked well because that solid 3 hours of block time was me time that I'm going to focus. So that's one thing that definitely helped us. The second thing that we also started to do was forcing people to shut down their laptop. What happened, and this was challenging because people are both working and after work also being entertained using laptop because that's the only means you have. Like if you are not doing this, probably you're watching Netflix or YouTube. That's also laptop. Even at that point, if somebody pings you, your brain will go, oh, what about that work? So we really need to help our team establish some level of more discipline saying, hey, take some laptop time off. Don't be online at all. But that was challenging because if you're not online, what do you do?
Yeah, so in our case, being a small studio, we had different challenges. Like, so like I mentioned, we are 10 people, out of which half of the team is a core team who is right there from the beginning of the studio. And then there are young people. So the whole team is very young. They're not really experienced in using tools very effectively. And that was one of the reasons that when we used to, work together in a physical space, there was a lot of to and fro communication happening between the core team and the people who are working on the projects, right? So it was like to and fro, and whatever file transfers used to happen, they used to happen on IP messenger, normal IP messenger. It was like very quickly, connected on LAN, and we just used to do that. But the biggest challenge when we shifted to work from home was to manage the whole team together and firstly educate them to get onto the digital tools, use those tools very well, and then, you know, make the whole process very effective. And one of the most important things that we did was introduction of Slack. Like Sumit said, I totally believe it now that I'm using it very rigorously. I totally believe it that in a big team, it's like a chaos. It's definitely chaos because there can be multiple channels. But for a small team, I think this is working for us really well because there are only 5 to 6 channels. And we have just separated our people into those channels which correspond to particular projects. And then we, you know, easily communicate and file transfer in the same window.
Can you name, if it's possible or if it's not proprietary, the kind of tools that you're using now? How will they work?
We are primarily all communication on Slack and all housekeeping on Google Sheets and Google Docs. So if you're doing reviews, it is in presentations, so Google Sheets. If it is on Word spec documents, it is there. And, you know, it is just amazing collaborative. People can comment, you can keep track of things. It just works. It also leads to just too many sheets because you can continuously make copy after copy after copy. So you have to be a bit due diligent there. So Slack, Google Sheet, all this. We also operate at least our QA team on all of Jira. So all our bugs and all the bug triage happens on Jira. But Slack is amazing. It can connect to Jira. It has got all these APIs already connected. So these are the three things that is currently really working well for us.
Yeah, and for us, the communication happens in Slack, spending time on things which we are not supposed to actually, but using tools like TeamViewer and, doing some visual tools. Also, if there's any brainstorming kind of thing which we have to do, it's usually online whiteboards also that we use.
Rajesh, in our world, we are using both. We are given the freedom for people. People will prefer Hangouts because it is super easy. When you are scheduling a meeting, you have to just tap one button, Hangout meeting happens, or a meet meeting happens immediately. But I think over a period of time, people have started tilting towards more Zoom. People have this, we have not done any analysis on it, but people intensely feel that Zoom is smoother, faster, better. It has got fun things like change your background. So, but it's open. There was a bit of frustration because if suddenly somebody sends an invite on Zoom and you're not on Zoom, so you have to go through this large process of installing it. But I think it was a one-time pain and I think we've overcome that pain.
So how have you adapted to things that are usually done best face-to-face?
In Hangout also or in Zoom also, we are face-to-face. So I think it means more than face-to-face, right? I think it again boils down to communication and ease of communication. You're seeing the body language. You're feeling the energy. All these kind of things that a lot of design people speak about, which I also feel I might not be able to articulate that in words. I first of all believe that it is not possible to replicate it. At least I feel so. Maybe at VR holograms in the near future you can. It's not possible. So first thing that we did was we removed the anxiousness in people. When people used to get frustrated, we made it an acceptable thing to be frustrated. If you're frustrated that my video call is not good, you might keep on saying, hey, Sumit, I can't hear you. Your video is not good. This will lead to a frustration, right? I will feel frustrated. What is this? So first we made that it's okay to be frustrated. Don't feel stressed out. Don't feel anxious. Now, once that happened to the mental model, right, people started losing this, you know, there's an inner feeling that, oh, my internet is being judged or I'm being judged. So that gets removed. The second thing that we ask people to have fewer people in a meeting, like this is a good size, 4 people at least. Of course, there are many people who are watching us, but like 3 people having a conversation and face to face. We insisted that do not do audio only call, do a video call. And also suggested some practices to be prepared before. We have done what is called the Indian Jugaad system, like take your laptop, keep it like this, actually take a pen and just start to draw, right? Be more. Do not be dependent on a best method to do this right.
Yes, I totally agree with Sumit. Like it's hard to eradicate it completely. For us, being a small studio, the major creative stuff or the quality check or the the core design stuff, right? It's always coming from the core people. So it's me who manages all these things or initiates all these things, spending a lot of time with people to make them understand what to do. So that's one thing where a lot of my time is going into using tools like, just as I said, like TeamViewer, like just opening his machine and, you know, guiding him through that half an hour. What this is the basic thing that you have to do, get it done by the end of the day. And I think it's worth spending that much time with those people. The biggest challenge that I face right now is meet that person in real, look into their eyes and see what is wrong with their life. That's what I'm missing a lot. Like I cannot judge what my guy is going through right now on that video call or whatever things are there, so that I can fix that up. So that's my biggest struggle right now.
When the question is, how do you keep morale high? The first question is, do we understand morale? Is everybody's morale the same? Would you be excited about the same thing versus me? It's a fairly complex and a detailed subject, in my opinion. And we came up with actually an official program called Work From Home 2.0. Consolidated this problem of morale into three categories. The first category is the employee wants to be productive. They actually want to feel happiness of work well done. And that is very important. Like when you do a good job, you know it, you feel it. And that is important. Number one, right? You are doing a job, you are being productive, and you're completing your job. And I have already spoken about a bunch of things about Slack and stuff like that in my previous thing. The second one was social connect and entertainment. If you are young, Rajesh, go back, right? Go to office, work your ass off, in the evening, go out and party. That's it, right? Like, what would else there be? And most of the time, I used to always party with my colleagues itself. My colleagues were my friends as well, right? There's no difference.